Notion just launched a brand new update called Notion AI for Work for business and enterprise plans, which will allow you to have even more AI capabilities like AI meeting notes, use the web as a source, and chat with the latest AI models like GPT 4.1 and Claude Sonnet 3.7. I'll be going over each of these updates along with explaining the new pricing and my general thoughts about it. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first major feature that I wanted to share with you all is this AI meeting notes. To access AI meeting notes, all you have to do is type /meeting and you can access the AI meeting notes. And then after that, you can get started with it. It's very fast. This is actually a block, which means that you can move it to any part of a Notion page, which makes it very versatile. And if you have an empty page, you also see this option at the bottom of the page. With this AI meeting note block, you can first play an audio consent message by clicking this one or copying the consent message through here. And once you confirm the consent, then you can start recording the meeting. If you want to change the settings, you can go to the three dots here and then change the language. You can change the format of this. So you can either do auto, sales call, stand up, team meeting. You can change the consent message as well as the voice here as well. And you can delete the transcript, copy link to block, move to, and delete. You can also connect this to Notion Calendar, which makes it even more useful, especially if you're using all the different Notion tools. Next, we can click the confirm consent to try it out. So you can just click here and Notion AI immediately starts to record this, write it here. So what makes this really useful is that you don't necessarily only have to use this inside of a video meeting. You can also use this when you are in a physical meeting as well. You really just have to open up Notion to use it. The only downsides I would say for this new AI meeting notes is that you can't really see who is the speaker because the AI meeting notes isn't joining through, for example, Zoom. So it can't see who is the speaker, which is something I like about other AI note takers. And the other thing is that immediately after it's transcribed, it deletes the actual recording. So you don't get an actual recording of it. You only get the transcription. So I hope that these are things that Notion improves in the future. But I think this is a really unique and cool first step to seeing these AI meeting notes. Once you're done with the meeting, you can hit the stop button. The next thing that it's going to do is generate the title as well as the summary. You can click here to also write your own notes. So during the meeting, if you have your own notes or an agenda, you can have that here, but still have the AI summary over here. Next, let's talk about some unique use cases and some ideas for taking this beyond AI meeting notes. So after trying this AI meeting notes out, I was thinking that it would be a really good idea to actually have this block as a database template. So if you have, for example, a database here, database inline, and then you have a meeting notes database, I would highly recommend if you want to get started with using the Notion AI meeting notes to go to the blue button here, click plus new template, and you can create a new template, new meeting note. And inside here, I would add the AI meeting note block already inside and then click out. So what this does is that when you click open a new meeting note, you can immediately have that block appear here and you can get straight to recording the meeting and transcribing it. I would recommend doing this into your meeting note database if you have one. The second feature that I wanted to highlight is that actually you can just use this as a personal note taker as well. You don't necessarily have to be in a meeting. If you have a bunch of ideas that you want to talk about and then have AI sort of sort that through for you, this is a really cool feature that you can use as well. If you type /AI, again, you can see the AI meeting notes. And just like I showed before, you can just simply start talking and then it's going to transcribe it and then summarize it. Another use case for this is that you don't necessarily have to be the speaker. You can also be watching, for example, a YouTube video. So let's say that I have this video, best use cases for callout boxes in Notion. I can go ahead and confirm consent. And then what I can do is just start playing the video. So as you can see, it actually transcribed the video that I was watching and now it's generating a summary about it. So this is another thing that you can try out if you want to actually take notes of other things besides meetings as well. The next feature I wanted to cover is that you can now choose which AI model to use. So to access the AI, you can go to the sidebar here and then go to home. When you're in home, you can see that there's now a button here that you can click, and it's going to show Notion AI, also OpenAI GPT 4.1, Anthropic Claude 3.7 Sonnet. So if you want to chat only with GPT 4.1, you can choose this one and then start asking GPT 4.1 various questions. If you want to use Claude instead, you can choose to chat with Claude. So I think this is a huge thing that they have added now, to be able to actually choose the AI model. Before, it would say that it's using GPT and Claude, but you didn't really know which it's actually using. So next, let's go over the new research mode. You can make thorough research reports that takes all the information that's inside of your workspace, as well as use the web for various sources as well. So to test this, what I did was I wanted to see what kind of activities the Organized Notebook has done in 2025. So I basically wrote create a report about, and then I clicked enter. To do this research mode, it does take some time because it really goes through everything that it can look for inside of your workspace and also outside of your workspace. So you do need to give it some time, but I was really happy with the results that it came up with. So Notion AI has now given me the report that they've created about 2025's updates at the Organized Notebook. And I'm honestly pretty impressed with what they found and the way that they put everything together based on so much information that's in the current workspace. So it basically listed out all of the major products and feature updates in 2025, showed what kinds of new videos that have been posted, as well as new templates. So I think this is really cool feature that you can use, especially if you have a really large organization. The next feature I wanted to cover are the AI connectors. So this is what allows you to also search for information outside of Notion from things like Slack or your Google Drive and more. So with this new Notion AI for Work update, you have way more apps that they have as a connector, and it seems like they're going to put even more effort into making these connections. To access this, you can go to this All Sources here and then Connect Apps, and then you can see what kinds of connectors there are. There's Google Drive, GitHub, and Jira, but more are on its way, and you will be able to add even more. Microsoft Teams, SharePoint, and OneDrive as a beta, and then Gmail, Linear, Zendesk, and Salesforce is coming as a preview. So, and it's going to be on its way. So I think that there's going to be a way more focus on trying to get all of these apps connected so that you can easily just search through them while you're inside of Notion. For the first time, Notion is going to be increasing their price in their business plan, as well as having an enterprise limited plan. So the reason for this pricing change is mainly that now Notion AI is going to be included as part of your plan if you have the business or enterprise plans. And if you already have a plus plan with a Notion AI upgrade, for example, you might be wondering, how is that different from the Notion AI upgrade? So with the Notion AI upgrade, it only includes the core features of Notion AI, things like database properties and AI blocks. But with the business and enterprise plans, you get the full Notion AI for Work features, like the AI meeting notes, the research mode, and all of these things. Regarding upgrading, I think that with this new change, if you're currently on the plus plan with an AI upgrade, it makes a lot of sense to just switch to the business plan, since you get way more features and AI is already included. There are also other non-AI features like the page verifications, conditional forms, and more that are also only available on the business plan or higher. If you're on the plus or free plan and happy without any AI features, then I think sticking to the same plan makes sense. Overall, this new update makes the business plan a more compelling upgrade option. If you're already paying for a business plan or higher and don't use AI, this could be a disappointing pricing change, as you get even more AI features and have to pay an increased price for it. From my perspective, the major benefit is for those who have been paying for a Notion AI add-on on top of the various Notion plans, and this makes it more simplified and unified across the different plans. I'm personally excited for these new features, as I use Notion AI inside of my workspace on a daily basis. I hope you found this video useful. Let me know in the comments about your thoughts, and I hope to see you all in the next video.